episode of Crazy Town Gaming, where we are the voice inside your head. I'm Jonas.
And I'm TNT Dan. I'm Mike the Explosive One, and we're playing the Quarry.
Yep.
All right, Jonas, last episode, we crashed.
Saw the flyer over here.
We crashed the car? Not really.
Drove off road?
Yeah.
Technically, I guess that's crashing.
Yeah, I know. Like, he was talking about all the damage done to the car. I'm like, dude, just drive that ish to the road.
Right. Well, the funny thing is like, you didn't hit anything, and he's looking at the engine. Exactly. Like, it would be all damage to the underneath of the car. But anyways.
Exactly. And then our main heroine here decided, oh, you know what I'll do is go wander off into the woods by myself and see if I can find a woman whose voice I heard. I heard a womanly voice.
Oh, no, what's this?
It was a secret, dude. I saw that hall wug. Oh, this looks safe.
Yeah, what is that? It's like a bridge. Broken cage. Says, the decrepit cage has been engulfed by the woods over time. It looks like an animal has nested here.
Oh, no, dude. Come on, man.
Dog boy.
Dog boy?
It's Jonas.
Yeah, yes. Hey guys! No. You guys want to watch it? We're going to episode.
Dog.
This is too weird.
Yeah, this is too weird. It's right.
Can you walk on the bridge? Can you go forward? Oh, that's the cage.
That's the cage. Yeah. That's okay. The dog boy cage.
So you got to come back and go around,
which is
okay.
Very, very weird. So yeah, it seems as though we are just creeping ever closer.
Well, I wonder, if you, would have caught the phone in the first episode if we wouldn't have then crashed, too. Like, I wonder if that's an option.
Jonas, anything to put blame on me?
I don't know how many different options this game has.
Oh, the frick is okay! Look, man. Look, lady. No. We don't play that here. We don't play. Come the frick out. I got a flashlight and a hat, and I will frickin' hurt your life. I will frick your whole life, lady. I saw you. All right.
Dude. Yeah, this is weird.
All right, I don't like it. Let's keep
so
going.
I guess I don't. Yeah,
keep going. It's a choose your own adventure, but it changes all the time. This is the part of the reason I keep talking about Until Dawn. It's like there's so many different things you could do that could totally change the story.
Oh, okay. So that helps keep the replay value.
Excuse me?
It helps keep replay value because it changes.
Yeah. I was referring to the wolf, Silas. Sorry? Excuse me?
Is that the other guy's name, her boyfriend's? Is his name Silas?
I don't know. I'm just trying to hug all the walls. Is someone behind me?
Oh, we're not controlling anymore. Okay.
No, I'm controlling it.
Oh, are you? Oh.
Yeah. I'm definitely controlling. I don't know where I'm
walking so far away from where
I don't know. Dude, you're right. It's insane. Just killing your phone battery.
Right? Dumbass lost his hell in the woods, chasing a woman.
Oh,
that's creepy.
Where's my QTE for that? I'm ready. Fingers ready. Finger ready. I'm ready for any button, dude.
Yeah, something's
Where are you?
I know all the controls.
Okay.
All right. How many times are we going to spin the camera around and have her looking frantic?
Silence.
Oh, somebody just whispered Silas in here and she started running.
Yep, that sounds about right. Oh, man. Good thing you put yourself in this situation.
All right. Yeah, why would you separate?
Because people
Quick
are
time event.
Duck. Ooh, that's very similar to the cartoon they showed me.
Yeah, right?
I got the reference very easily. Up. Ooh.
Okay, you're a winner.
Where's the cat?
Hey, what's wrong? What's wrong? Is everything all right?
Holy shit.
Talk to me. What's going on?
Man, you should let her trip.
There's something out there. There was noises all around me.
Honey, take a breath. It's okay. It's the woods. There's a lot of stuff out there. There's animals. It's easy to freak yourself out.
No. Can we just leave, please?
Yeah. Let's go.
Yeah. Let's go. Good idea. Where's red coming from in the back of the car?
I don't know.
I'm so scared, dude.
There we go. Purring like a king.
Max, come on.
Here we go. We're getting out of here.
Now we're stuck.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my God.
Max!
I just, okay, give me a minute.
The worst thing you can do is
we've got to go, Max.
Right, you're not helping me.
Can you just, I am trying to get us out of here.
All right, enough!
How is she trying to do
shit, I'm sorry, honey.
Go get a log.
Okay, it's okay.
Anything, jam it under the tire.
Yep, keep spinning. We're okay.
We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Oh! Ready?
Oh my god, my heart just exploded.
He has blood on his neck.
Roll it down.
Is that Norman Reedus?
How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
Why does he have blood on his neck?
I don't know, dude, because he's a freaking backwoods cop. They all have blood on their necks. Comes with the uniform.
Oh, he's pushing.
You folks want to tell me what happened here?
Nothing. Path chosen.
Hackett's quarry is full of twists and turns, unknown paths and unexplored wonders. With each step taken, you tread a path of your own, matched with its very own consequences. There will be moments throughout your stay that show you that the choices you've made, the path you've chosen, could have gone another way.
Oh,
at Hackett's
cool.
Quarry, there's no such thing as the wrong way. But be warned, some paths are more dangerous than others.
Okay. So essentially, because I took that way that led me back, I could have gone... There was two different ways I could have gone, essentially, there. One of them might have led me somewhere else, but I came back around.
Oh, to get back to him.
When I was lost in the woods.
Oh, there was an alternate way?
Yeah, because I was going forward, and then I noticed that there was a path that led around back, and I was like, well, natural video game in me was like, I'll go around back, but there was also a point for me to continue going forward.
Oh, gotcha.
So there's this different paths.
All right, cool, cool.
Yeah, seems pretty cool.
And this might be one of these moments,
yeah.
Too.
Oh,
evasive or honest?
Never lie.
We, something jumped out right in front of the car and we didn't want to hit it, so we swerved and... Now here we are.
Something jumped out?
It was an animal.
An animal. You know, yeah. It's just, don't know what kind. It was so fast and...
You just said always be honest.
Yeah. Well, it was most likely a deer.
There we go!
Sir? Keep the car running.
Alright, always be honest, except don't be honest.
Okay. Okay, so that's what I figured.
The all-time
like.
Scariest cop?
I don't know, this is my first cop.
What, like ever?
First cop?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Well, they're just kids.
Yeah. But also saying, like, it's an animal, like, it very well could have been, you know what I mean?
Exactly. I mean, in my book, Jonaas, humans are animals, right? Oh, thank you, Ossifer.
Oh, he got us straight up onto the road again?
Oh, Ossifer, thank you so much.
We went way far off the road, by the way.
Right?
Now, you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
What? I'm asking you the same question.
Friendly?
Yeah.
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp.
Probably should have told him.
Counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out, you know? I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
Escort?
Good luck.
Police escort?
You're not gonna make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight.
Why?
Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am. You're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
What do we do?
You can ask, why not Hackett's Quarry? Or...
With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Oh, wow.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem.
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Go. Ma'am, if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle, I would just like to show you a route on your map there.
Sure.
This guy is,
Son?
The cop?
Remain in the vehicle.
He's a little intense.
He's getting impatient.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, he should be a little on edge, but...
Why is the cop telling him to go stay at a motel? That's weird.
That's weird. He must know something we don't,
okay.
Though.
Okay. So, we...
All
right, about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
What a D. You won't even show us how to get there.
No, dude. This gives me, like, House of a Thousand Corpses vibes, right?
Right. He's like, oh, there's a house up there you can go talk to.
Yeah, right.
Y'all want to see Dr. Satan?
Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road. Watch out for potholes.
Don't you need, like,
have
a statement?
Have a good night.
Why would he need a statement?
Because he's got to write it up, right? After
report. Know. We just pulled him out of the thief's uses. I mean, he didn't do anything.
They got to report, like, everything, though, right?
I don't think so.
I mean, one of them is like, yeah, this one cop, he helped.
There's another guy in the car. No, there's not.
Dude, I wouldn't be surprised. All right.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
That guy was weird.
I don't know. Or...
That guy was giving me major weirdo
the
vibes.
Dude needed, like, at least a dozen showers.
Oh, my God, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Oh, on his neck, right. Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
He just shoots through the back of the car and blows his head off. Pulls her out, bashes her face in.
All right.
Game
Let's
over.
Let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
I agree. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here,
mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's Quarry.
Yeah.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Wait a second.
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop?
He didn't show
us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel.
No, that sounds terrible. Yeah. Let's hit the road, shall we?
I say we go to the motel, ma'am. If we get to choose.
Oh, my God. If he called me ma'am one more time, I was going to shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am. What?
20's debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done.
I'm into ma'ams. So. All right. And on the next episode, we'll see if we get to Hackett's Quarry.
All right. That's all the time we have for this episode. Please make sure to like and subscribe. If you did that, hit the notification bell for Jonaas.
TNT.
We out.